His whole idea that, well, you know, there are these paradises around the world that have limited government, like Africa. What is he kidding? Africa is drowning in government. The place is overrun by warlords. I mean, there's no private property in sub-Saharan Africa. You can't start a business there. I mean, it is massive, a government in places like that. And for him to say that, you know, that the United States is the example of the least amount of government, and that you can't find any other country that has less government than America that is more prosperous, is just sheer nonsense. And it also ignores the long history of the United States. See, he believes that we didn't have any prosperity until we created Social Security, until we created Medicare and Medicaid, and until we had government schools and all these big government departments. The country was far richer, and he always likes to fall back on this analogy to say, well, would you rather live in the 19th century than the 20th century? That's not the point. Obviously, there has been technological advancements between the 19th century and the 20th century. The question is, how many more advancements would we have had we stayed on the old trajectory? Where I would like to live is in 20th century America, or, you know, 21st century America, with 19th century government. In fact, I want to live in 21st century America where we had 19th century government the entire time, because I would be living in a country that was nothing like anywhere else on planet Earth. The standard of living that we would have as a society, the things that we would have produced, is unimaginable to us right now. I mean, who could... Our standard of living would be so high. I mean, our life expectancy could be 150 by now. I mean, people might only be working 2 days a week, right? And they're probably, you know, I mean, we would have so much. We would have such a high standard, but you can't see all of that. You can't see the progress that wasn't made because of all the government that we created. Yet you can see the progress that was made and somehow try to credit government for that, when that's bad logic. It's not, we didn't create the achievements that we did because of government. We did that despite government. And if we would have had a lot less government, we would have achieved that much more. That's the point, you know.